organizer and to everyone who is an important exchange. Today I will present at first the geographic and historical frame and the current state of the research in my research area and period, then the method, and then some specific research questions that I presided for the today's session in accordance with this, and then the practical application in a pilot test, and finally a prospect and to-do list. In my postdoctoral research project, I'm dealing with the Hellenistic period in northern Etruria, it means in middle Italy, and really I started to collect data a bit before of the official beginning of the Hellenistic period, so 350, and then I will go to collect them, and I'm collecting them a bit until the end of this period in the Caesarian age. Dealing with the Hellenistic period in central Italy means to deal with a hot topic of the research in classical archaeology. It means with the topic of Romanization. That it was in the last 20 years much discussed, especially because we are shifting as a community, the research community, from a rigid point of view of Romanization as a political conquest or acculturation and integration in a Roman Empire to more fluid conception as a switching code, hybridization, cultural transmission. In my own position in the history of the research is naturally in this second group. Every approach of Romanization has something in common, even the rigid one. And that's this is a relational process. For this reason, I've chosen as method the social network analysis, because the strong point of the method is the relationality. And as a node of my network, I choose local communities, and I'm interested in local responses of local communities to a global process of restructuration in this period. And these communities are tied and linked through hedges that can be established on relational ties, on different criteria. Since I'm interested in the complexity of Romanization, I've chosen to work on a network for different criteria from connectivity and mobility. I will talk about today, but also economic exchange and cultural transmission and so on. And building then a multi-layer network and study finally the transversal interaction between different components of this process, so different relational ties. And since I'm interested in a process, I need a longitudinal network, and we have seen that many times today we can work on artificial period and phases, and I divided the phases in part on the criteria of the Venetian history, that's the Punic Wars are changing very much the asset of the Mediterranean, the Western Mediterranean in particular. Then to the specific research question for today, that's the question of resilience. And I understood this resilience as a local response to a stress situation directed to restore the integrity of a system. In dealing with resilience, I have to confront with different level or kind of agency. The urban agency understood as the agency of urban central local communities and their reciprocal interactions, but also of the agency of single segment of the society within the cities. Especially for literary source, we know that within the Tuscan cities there were different parties and people interacting in a very different way during this period with the Roma power. And since I'm an archaeologist, I'm dealing with many different sources to answer my questions, and each source allow to build a different kind of networks. And today I will deal with epigraphic sources for the mobility network and topographic sources for the connectivity network. The topographic sources have been collected not directly from me, but from the literature, and the primary source are surveys and excavation collected in the project of the University of Siena, the archaeological chart, and in some other local projects. And I've chosen as a criterion of this connectivity to establish a buffer of 5 kilometer distances from each center in linear distance. The second network I will show is on the Thai kinship, and is based on the epigraphic sources and is allowed but by the special condition of the Etruscan sources in this period. For Hellenistic Etruria, we have about 80,000 inscriptions, mostly of them are funerary. They are not all concentrated in northern Etruria, where I'm working into. And on the inscriptions, there's the family name of people and family name of bride and husbands. It means it's possible to partially reconstruct the spirit of this onomastic within different graves. And I would like very much to study the real kinship, but for the moment I just studied the kinship through the diffusion of the onomastic. That's not exactly the same things, because the names have some stratifications. So yeah, I hope it's possible in the future to refine these methods and to find really the direct linkage between father, mother, and children buried in other graves. Now to my pilot test. I sampled the local communities in two areas in the territory of the city Chiusi, here in, a bit more in the south, near the Transimenic Lake, about 2,500 square kilometers, and then Volterra on the north, about the double of surface. And you can see that in within the three phases, that's an increasement of the settlement number or community numbers in Chiusi, and a decreasement in Volterra, and the average degree, so the average number of connections for between for each community, increasing Chiusi and stabilize itself, and it's the opposite tendency in Volterra. Then I started with the connectivity longitudinal network in Chiusi, and we can see from the structural point of view there's some minor center clustering around small cities, and then there's some huge cities that have a very high value of measurement of centrality, the between a centrality. Between a centrality measure, how many times a node, all other nodes has to pass a node to have contact with the other, and it means broker or bridge functions of this settlement. I've done it from the three phases. You can see easily the increasement of the number of, so the network numbers, so the number of the nodes, and some variation within the centrality measurement. Then I reported this, measurement of between a centrality on the map to see which variation I could have between them. And I've noticed that this high ranking of between a centrality is always present in the urban center here of Chiusi and Chianciano, where also the temple are, for example, or common infrastructure and city walls. But there are also a higher connectivity, between us connectivity on in this zone. Sorry. Yeah. And that's a series of hilltop settlement divided into valley. That's the Chiana valley and the Orta valley. And this between us ranking is moving with the phases to the north. Then I performed the same analysis for the network of Volterra, and you can see that for the mesh of 5 kilometers, but just for this mesh, the network is much fragmented, and just in the third phases, there are two territorial area join them in a network through some intermediate settlements. And that you can see the situation on the map, the variation of centrality measurement in this blue area is very low, so it's not so significant. That's an eigenvariation in this zone. And then here is where the network gets unified. And then I zoom in on this area, and I could observe that the value of a higher betweenness are concentrated in a urban context, but just on the south. Here, that's the borderline with the territory of QC, or the contact zone of the territory of QC. And we have a parallel situation on this hilltop settlements chain here, and where the value of the betweenness are moving to the south. Then I ask if I could compare the two, the situation in the two cities as a this key of strategies of resilience, and some analogies and some differences. The network of QC is much more entangled, and in Volterra much more fragmented, except for the third phases. Urban center maintain a centrality as broker in QC, and in Volterra are quickly invisible for this mesh of 5 kilometers, but I performed another experiment I will not show today for 10 kilometers is still published, and they have a very high value. So this scale question we discussed before is really important. Minor centers are in QC, a pole of attraction from small farmers or rural villages, and in the zone of Volterra is just on the south, so maybe in analogy of the neighbor territory. And farmers are in QC, affiliated to cities or minor centers, so very near the cities, while in Volterra there's a series of isolated farmers that were studied by Nicola Terrenato very well in the last time discussing urbanization. And finally, the hilltop settlement have shown to have strong analogies. They are also known, but we can follow with this method the shift in the chronology along the spatial line. My second point is the network of kinship. I performed that just for QC, especially because of the difficulties to understand some linguistic problem. I really would like to work with a specialist of Etruscan language to understand if some families are just different because there's a variation in the way to write their name, but maybe with the vocal they were not so solid as in other languages, a bit as in the Arabic language today, so they were not written always, so it's a bit difficult. But I tried, and then I studied the name of 51 families in an asymmetric network, and then I connected between them the cities they have the same family name, and I assumed here that the elite name, as in this time, the Hellenistic time, has strong significance, and so even if the people were not directly in a kinship relationship, so blood relationship, they are in a more wider relationships as an elite family. And then I studied the variation of the betweenness centrality, and in the two main cities, they are mostly for QC, the all three phases and height betweenness. Maybe in the function of pole of attraction, there are people that are moving to the city to live, especially in the third phase, and people moving also abroad. But we have two special situations here, and on the other side, on the west and on the east, linked with some economic hubs. Here near the Trasimenic Lake, in a very important agricultural zone, and here near the Amiata Mountain in a mineral zone. Then I wanted to understand if there were a relationship between the connectivity and the kinship of families. And I just have done a difference of this variation of between us. And I've seen that in there's an accordance of variation between first phase and second phase and second phase and third phase for connectivity and kinship in this peripheral area or economic apps area, where the presence of elite family that they exchange with order probably were related to the economic exploitment and also to the connectivity system. But in the center city, especially in Chianciano, there's a complementarity between the variation in the ranking of the connectivity and the variation in the ranking of the kinship. So about the strategy of the elite, there's an increasement of family connections in general along the three phases. The appearance of local hubs in area of economic interest, and a shared control of responsibility of urban elites in the territory during the Romanization, and that's correspond in the archaeological records with the evidence of social climbing and elite renovation, so they are not the traditional elites always. And the last slide is about which issue and which potential I see, but I will be glad obviously to share with you if someone has some comments on some other suggestions. Many issues and problems are in the lacunarity of the data and in the way the topographic data were collected. So I think a very strong point is from the archaeological point of view to improve the quality of the data, so to have not garbage in, garbage out, but maybe good data in and maybe good result out, we hope. And then the second problem is the decision making. So on which scale, with which scale I am going to work, or how do I decide that a group of sparse houses are a community or rather not? And the same things for the onomastic network, I'll have a bit to talk about this. And between the potential, I see especially the importance to interlock the network to understand how the different ties can relate each other. And then I aim in the future to go deeper in the permanence or abandonment from a traditional Etruscan identity markers as language and religion and other usages in the single node. So how do the evolution, structural evolution during the Romanization impact on local identity markers? Thank you very much.